Hi guys, welcome back. I got some requests to do some videos for how do I do pre-flight planning for icing. So let me show you what I'm going to walk through here today. Today is a really good example because as you look around at the weather, we have low ceilings and some rain and snow just passed through the area. So the clouds are ripe for icing. So we're going to see what that looks like as we look at the forecast. So a sky vector shows that we have 1,200 foot ceilings down to 900 foot ceilings as you go east towards Milwaukee. And you have broken clouds at 2,000 feet as the ceiling over here. So let's see what the various forecasts say about what we can expect for icing. So if you look at the AirMet, the problem with the AirMet forecast is it's very, very vague about a huge area of airspace. It says moderate icing from the surface to 15,000 feet. That does not mean that there is moderate icing everywhere in this area. It just means that you should be looking out for it. Common mistake is people say, oh, I can't fly anywhere in here, not even under the clouds, because I'm going to get icing. That's just not true. Unless there's freezing rain, if you're not flying through a cloud, you're not going to be picking up any ice. So that's one misconception I want to get rid of out there. So instead, the more specific forecasts are the FIP forecasts, which you can find by going to forecasts from aviationweather.gov to icing and then forecast icing. So this plots your maximum icing potential at the sum of all altitudes. And the red hatched portions are for where you might expect super cool large droplets. You don't want to play around with those because that can cause severe icing, and that's a really big problem. So what you can do is you can drill down to specific altitudes that you're interested in. This is an MSL. 1,000, 3,000 really starts to ramp up with its intensity. As we go up to 5 and 7,000, one thing I want to note is that you can click on, instead of severity plus SLD, you can go to severity, probability greater than 25%, and it will shade things in gray that are less than 25% chance of ice. So things that might look scary at the normal level, like around central Wisconsin here, when you click on this drop down, it'll say, oh, by the way, it's actually not too likely. Interestingly though, we did have an icing report in central Wisconsin. So you can go all the way up and figure out what's going on at higher altitudes, figure out your plan for how you want to get through the ice or avoid it, depending on your aircraft's equipment. So this to me is a really good forecast for icing. It's been really good, although you can sometimes get ice in areas that are forecasting no ice, and sometimes you can go through these darker shades of blue and get absolutely no ice. So another common misconception is that you're going to get ice if you fly into a cloud that's below freezing. That's just not true. There's a lot of clouds below freezing that have very low moisture content. Another thing you can consider is what is the thickness of the clouds that you're traveling through if you don't have ice protection, for example. So what you can do is you can go to the GFA tool. You go to the tools, GFA tool. This replaced the area forecasts. And then you can click on clouds. And then you can create a flight path. Suppose you're going from Madison to Milwaukee. It will put your flight path on this page. You can zoom in and see what the cloud cover is expected. So right now they're expecting 2,800 MSL up to tops of 7,000 around the route of flight. So if you climb up to 8,000, you're probably going to reach the tops and see beautiful blue skies up there. So that's something to keep in mind, is to know how thick the layers are. As we go west, we can see that there's a broken layer and the tops are at 6,000. Out here, broken 3,500, tops 5,000. Know where your outs are. Know that, hey, there's VFR to the west. In an emergency, I just go to the west and I can find a few clouds. So this is a really good kind of a high-level view, a bird's-eye view of where are my outs. You want to know where they are so you don't get trapped in or cornered by any icing. Other resources are pilot reports. You can see the orange ones are moderate icing. So this is a report, and notice the temperature, -6. We often see icing reports anywhere between -2 and -16. Once in a while you'll see them at 0. Once in a while you'll see them at like -18, -19. But usually ice disappears at -20. Usually the hot spots for ice are between -2 and -10. That's where you see the most ice. The reason being is that the atmosphere can hold more moisture when it's warmer, closer to freezing, than when it's like at negative 20 Celsius. Interesting things to note, it's during descent for this report. So what could happen is the aircraft's coming from a very, very cold atmosphere, and its fuel and its wings cooled down, and now you have these super cooled wings that are going through more moist atmospheric conditions, and it's more likely for them to pick up ice. So it's interesting to note, was the ice report during a descent or during a climb? That can tell you a lot about this. This is taken by a multi-engine Cessna. Again, minus six, moderate rime icing between 4,500 and 3,500 on the way down. So the pilot reports tool is really handy, although you can be listening to your live ETC for your local airport that you're interested in, because not all the pilot reports make it into aviationweather.gov. A lot of the times you're going to get a lot more fresh, relevant data just by listening to the radio than you will by looking at this. But this is still nonetheless a good tool. You can also narrow down the data, the time of the data, by going to configure. You can say the last 12 hours, or maybe you only want the last 2 hours. What happened the last 2 hours? There's negative report of icing at 8,000 over here, and then there was light icing between 2,800 and 6,800 out here. Again, minus six for the temperature. So as you study these, you get to see trends for where ice typically shows up. For me, I'm the most nervous about ice when it starts getting negative one, negative two. That's when it's like the most ripe for ice. Again, know how thick your clouds are that you're going through. If it's a really thin layer, then there's a chance that it might be less than 30 seconds that you travel through it, and not much ice might build up. So that, know where your outs are. Another interesting plot is the temperature plot. And the way you get here is you get a forecast, winds and temps. And you go down below and you find this wind barb chart, and you change the temperature. And now you can go up in altitude. Sometimes the temperatures are going to get warmer as you climb with the temperature inversion. It's really nice to know if you have warm air above you. The only time you're going to know for sure is if you climb up there to look for it. It's good to use these forecasts to know, do I have a temperature inversion? Also, windy is kind of useful for this. You can drop a point and it will tell you what the freezing altitude is. You can also look at the temperatures as well, and use the slider on the right to select which altitude you're talking about. So up in the flight levels, it's negative 39. That's pretty cold. So you can imagine if your fuel is you know, in the negative 30 range, and you come down near freezing temperatures, you're more likely to pick up ice than if your wings came from warmer temperatures. Another interesting thing you can do with Windy is you can right-click or press and hold on the mobile interface and go to sounding, and you can look at the skew-t charts. Now, I'm not a super huge fan of whether or not it's important to be able to interpret these, but the interesting thing is, note whether or not the temperature is getting colder or warmer as you climb. So if this red line for the temperature ever goes to the right, it means that the air is getting warmer as you climb, which is a temperature inversion. And the blue line is dew point. So if the dew point meets the temperature, that means that you usually have clouds in that area. So here, looking at this chart, it looks like clouds are between 5,000 and 7,000 for this point in the future for the forecast. So the interesting thing to note about these skew-t charts is just look at the slant of the red line. If it's almost vertical, then that means it's a pretty stable atmosphere. The temperature isn't changing much as you climb. Expect smooth air. If it's just a really flat line directly to the left, that means it's getting cold really quick, and it's probably unstable air and probably very bumpy. So there's a lot you can learn through these forecasts about how smooth the air is, and especially a temperature inversion is really cool when the line actually goes the opposite direction. That's all I had today for this tip about how to look for icing in the forecasts. Fly safe out there. Know your personal minimums. If you decide to never fly into a cloud that's below zero, I don't blame you. You're in good company. But just know that not all clouds below zero contain ice. And it's important that you figure out the moisture content of these clouds by looking at these relevant forecasts and figuring out where you might find ice. and know that if there's an air met for icing between the surface and 15,000 feet for moderate icing, it doesn't mean that you're going to get moderate icing everywhere. That is a gross oversimplification and it's wrong. So either know the forecasts. I would say really do your homework before you go into clouds that are below zero, or just don't go into them at all. So you can either choose to really do a lot of homework and figure out if you're going to get ice, listen to the pilot reports, listen to the radio with live ATC, or just don't fly into clouds below freezing at all. And look out for the SLD. Do not fly into that. Do not fly anywhere near freezing rain. One interesting thing about freezing rain in forecasts is if you see it in the terminal area forecast, the TAF, it might just mean that the surface is below freezing, that when the warm rain hits the cold surface that it freezes, which impacts aircraft braking. But there's a very small chance that even if you see freezing rain in the TAF, that it might not mean that the rain is freezing through freezing cold temperatures. It might be +2 or +3 degrees Celsius outside, but it might just be hitting a super cooled runway, which turns it into ice. So that's one small nuance with freezing rain that's important to know, because I've seen that before, where I knew the temperature outside was 36 degrees Fahrenheit, like, you know, +2 or +3 Celsius. Like, why is freezing rain in the forecast? The reason is that when it hits the runway, it freezes, and then you might skid off the runway if you land there. So it's still important to know. With that, that's all that I have for this forecast. I look forward to hearing from your comments in the section below. I love discussing aviation safety. That's what my channel is all about. If you want to learn more or see more videos, I have plenty in my channel. Please check them out, and please hit the like or subscribe buttons. I'd appreciate that. All right, thanks. I'll see you guys later.